It's November 4th. The deer gone crazy this morning. We had a hot doe come through about 50 yards away. I couldn't have shot him. It's too dark. And then a buck trailed her. And then a bigger buck trailed her. I couldn't tell the second one to shoot her. And I think I just laid eyes on the second one. They crossed back over. And in the field, a small form. I think a shooter ate. We were fighting. Chased off the doe, hopefully they come back this way, but we're sitting at a pinch point where they cross, and I'm able to see the field where the doe was feeding. They're just getting chased like crazy. The bigger buck left to chase that doe, and the young buck thinks he owns the place. But it's a pretty eventful morning. That's why we didn't see anything last night. So this hot doe must have had him chasing somewhere else. Pop out every once in a while. And then there's a bigger buck. A few bucks on cam. I, in particular, think it's is this one buck that we've had a few times on camera. That hot doe came over here this morning, followed by two deer. I think it was that six and this other buck. They were sparring in the field this morning. Then she ran pretty quickly. She wasn't on her side for that long. Back to their side, and I haven't seen her since. She's been chased around in there. I think one of these books has run locked down. But we'll see what happens. Nothing will happen. I hope she gets up at some point and walks her way towards me.
Despite the excitement, the dens, and the few bucks in the field, stay tuned for part 2 where things get crazy.